Hello friends, today we will learn the summary of the lesson Tom Paints the Fence. This is taken from Read It Yourself section from the Blossoms English textbook of 7th standard. On to the summary now. Tom paints the fence. Fence means the fencing. Fencing means generally around the garden we make a fencing in order to protect the plants from the animals like cows, goats, buffaloes, sheep and everything. Okay, so fencing is like a border. How we make a compound wall, the same way fencing is made of wood. Some sticks are used to make the fencing. Okay, and those are painted every year. Yeah, to keep them safe from being rotten. Generally wood gets rotten away, or the insects go inside the wood and they spoil it. To avoid it, they paint it so that it can last long. It will not be affected by the insects. Okay, so here Tom paints the fence. Now Tom is given the work of painting the fence, and here Tom is painting the fence. Let us see how he paints the fence. Okay, Tom was a young, imaginative and mischievous 12-year-old boy. Yeah, these are the adjectives. They are defining what type of boy Tom was. He was a young boy. Yeah, and then imaginative, he had lot of imaginations. Yeah, that is, he could imagine very quickly, and his imagination was very special. It was more special than the other children. Okay, imaginative and mischievous. Mischievous means naughty boy. Okay, Tom's mother had passed away. Passed away means died. Tom's mother died. Instead of passed away, you can say died also, departed also, expired also. Okay. Tom's mother had passed away. Tom doesn't have a mother now. Okay. He was living with his aunt Polly on the banks of the river Mississippi. As he had no mother, he was living with his aunt. Okay. And his aunt's name was Polly. Okay, and they lived on the banks. Banks means on the shore, you can say. For sea, you can say shore. For river, the edge is called the bank. Okay, banks of the river Mississippi. Mississippi is the name of the river. Okay, so you can see the name in capital letters. Okay, Mississippi. She loved him as much as she loved her sister. That is, his aunt Polly, she loved Tom as much as she loved Tom's mother. Okay, her sister is Tom's mother. Okay, the aunt knew that if you spare the rod, you will spoil the child. This is a proverb. Spare the rod, spoil the child. This means if there is a rod, generally parents beat the children when they do some mistake. Yeah, if they don't beat the children, what happens? Children get spoiled. That is, if we think that it will pain for the rod, if I beat with the rod, spare the rod means if you allow the rod to take rest, the child will be spoiled. That means she was a very strict person. Yeah, she believed that if Tom has to be a good boy, she has to discipline him. She has to teach him discipline. Okay, so she was very strict, and she even used to beat him when he did some mistakes. Okay, the aunt knew that if you spare the rod, you will spoil the child. Okay, she wanted to be strict or he would grow up lazy and be spoiled. So she was a very strict person. Yeah, so she wanted to bring him up in a right way. One day the aunt thought to herself. One day this aunt Polly thought to herself. What did she think? I'll make him work tomorrow. It's mighty hard to make him work on Saturdays when all the boys are on a holiday. The aunt had asked Tom to paint the fence. So Aunt Polly had a plan. She wanted Tom to work on Saturdays, but she knew it was very difficult to make Tom to work on a Saturdays because on that day all the other boys were on holiday. When all the others are playing and enjoying, will Tom do the work? No, not at all. Still for all, she had the plan. Okay. And what did she do? She asked Tom to paint the fence. This is the assignment for Tom. He has to paint the fence. Yeah. Saturday morning came. It was a bright day, a sunny day. Okay. The hill behind the village was covered with summer green. So all the area was sunny now. Yeah. And the village was also covered with summer green. So this shows that it is summer season. Okay. Tom appeared on the pavement with a bucket of whitewash and a long-handled brush. So his aunt has given him the work to paint the fence. So he put all those paint, that is, you generally use the limestone for painting, so that he mixed in the water, yeah, and he put it in a bucket and put water and he mixed it. That is a bucket of whitewash, means the limestone mixed in water. Yeah. He came on the pavement with the bucket of whitewash and a long handled brush. There was a brush to paint the fence. He surveyed the fence. Surveyed means he is looking from there to here. He is taking the measure. How long is the fence? Okay. He surveyed the fence. 30 yards of broad fence. Yeah. So the fence was 30 yards. This is the measure of the fence. And 90 feet high. So you can imagine this was a big fence. This was a huge area that he has to paint now. Okay. And it was high also. So he has to go up or he has to stretch himself and he has to paint. Yeah. Life to him seemed hollow. Existence but a burden. Life to him seemed hollow and existence but a burden. So when he thought that he should paint such a big fence, immediately he felt very hollow, very sad. Oh, what is this life, man? How should I live this life? Always giving me work. On holiday also, aunt is making work. That way he started thinking, and existence but a burden. He did not want to live. Hey, what is this life? Like that he was thinking. Existence means living. Living became a burden, means he started feeling very sad about the painting. How should I paint? Like that he was thinking. Sighing means taking a deep breath, like that. Sighing, Tom dipped his brush and passed it along the topmost plank. So first you have to paint the topmost one, then when the paint comes down little bit, and then you can do the down part. Okay. So he went to the topmost plank. Plank means the wooden thing by which the fence is made. Wooden plank we call it. Yeah. So he started painting the top part of the fence, top plank. Okay. He began to think of the fun he had planned for the day, like going for swimming, and his sorrows multiplied. So as he started painting, he got the thought. What thought did he get? He thought of the fun. How much fun he had planned for the day. Oh, what I thought this Saturday, what all fun I thought, what all we should play, all that. I thought of swimming and I thought of playing and doing so many other things, but all this is gone. Today I have to paint the fence the whole day. As he thought about it, his sorrows multiplied. His sadness became even more. He became even more sad. Oh no, this whole day I have to paint the fence. How to do that? Like that he started thinking. Soon the boys who were free would come tripping along and they would ridicule him for having work to do. Now look at those boys. The other boys, what they did as he was painting the fence, they were coming there, come tripping means just like that, walking like that, or coming in their bicycle or some other way. They came towards Tom and they would ridicule, make fun of him. Hey, look at this fellow, he's painting the house, poor thing, he's painting the fence, look at this fellow, poor thing, he is painting the fence. Like that, they started making fun of him. And you know how we feel when people make fun of us. The same thing with Tom. He also felt very bad. Okay, the very thought of it upset him. Oh no, when these children told him that he was painting and they were all having fun, he felt even more upset. At this dark moment, he got a great magnificent idea. At this moment when all were making fun of him and he was missing all the fun he had planned for Saturday, at that moment, he got a great idea. Magnificent means very excellent idea, the marvelous idea. Yeah, what is that idea? He took up his brush and calmly resumed his work. So he was going on doing his work very sincerely. What is his idea? What idea did he get? Let us see. There came Ben Rogers. As he was sincerely painting, Ben Rogers came that side. The very boy of all boys whose ridicule he had been dreading. So what is the quality of Ben Rogers is he would make fun of Tom, and how he makes fun of Tom is he feels very bad about it. Dreading means very dreadful, very very much bad. That is, it's very it's in a very worst thing, like dreadful. When he teases Tom, Tom used to feel very bad. Okay, so that fellow, the Ben Rogers who used to tease very badly, that fellow came there. Ben was eating an apple and seemed to be in high spirits because it was Saturday and they were all on a holiday and they were all relaxing. This Ben Rogers was very happy. High spirits means very happy, and he was eating an apple. Tom went on whitewashing and paid no attention to Ben. He just ignored him. Even if he came, he did not look at him. Tom was sincerely painting the fence without looking at Ben Rogers. Ben said, "Hello, you have got to work even on a holiday." So he is now making fun of Tom as usual. Still, you have work on Saturday also. What is this? Like that, he is making fun. Tom replied, "I do not consider this as work because it gives me pleasure." Now I told you Tom had an idea, right? So what Tom did is, "This is not work, man. This is such a fun. I really enjoy painting." So he says, "I don't think this is work. It gives me pleasure. I enjoy doing it," he says. He went on painting the fence just like an artist. Now he was painting the fence as if he was so much interested in painting. He loved painting. He was enjoying painting like an artist. Yeah, with lot of interest he was painting. That way he was showing to Ben. Ben was watching all that and he was getting more and more interested. As he looked at Tom, yeah, painting with lot of interest, with lot of sincerity, this Ben was also getting the interest to paint the fence. Okay, so in a way, Tom was tempting Ben to get the interest into painting. Okay, Ben was watching all that and he was getting more and more interested. At last, Ben asked Tom, "Tom, let me whitewash a little." So he could not stop his temptation. Okay, at last he is requesting Tom, "Tom, Tom, please let me paint one plank. No, let me paint a little bit. Give me a chance," he is asking. Yeah, Tom answered negatively, saying, "My aunt is very particular about this fence and everybody cannot paint the whole of it right away." So what he said, no, I can't give it. Negatively means he is refusing to give. He does not want to give. He is not willing to give. So what did he say? "Aray, my aunt, you know, she's very strict. Yeah, and she told me to paint, I will only paint. Okay, and anybody and everybody, people like you cannot paint." Okay, he is telling. Ben was getting very eager and asked Tom. Now, you know, when people said us not to do, then only we feel like doing. Yeah, when mummy tells us not to do that, then only we go and do. The same way here, Tom said to Ben, no, 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 I can't give you. Then only Ben is getting even more tempted. Arre re, please give me. I will just once I will paint and give you. That way he was requesting Tom. Tom, I'll be very careful. Now let me try. I'll give you half of my apple. Now, as Tom was not giving him, he told, Arre, please give me one chance. I'll give you half of my apple. You can eat the apple and give me one chance to paint the fence, he said. Tom replied, no, sorry, I can't let you. I'm afraid. So again, he's telling, no, 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 I won't give you the chance. Ben begged him, means he pleaded him, he was requesting him, hey, please, one chance you give me, like that he was requesting him. I'll give you the whole apple. So he says, not half apple, man, I'll give you full apple, please give me one chance, I will paint the fence. Okay, and then Tom gave him the brush and Ben started painting while Tom sat down happily in the shadow of a tree eating the apple. Now, this was the trick of Tom. Somehow, he managed to make Ben Rogers work for him. Now, Ben was painting the fence and Tom was sitting and nicely enjoying the apple. Yeah, poor Ben was sweating and was working under the sun for a long time. So Ben was very happy that he got a chance to paint and he was going on painting. I said the day was very sunny, so it was very hot. So Ben was sweating. Yeah, when Ben was tired, Tom gave the brush to Billy, who gave him his kite in return. So as he tempted Ben to paint the fence, the same way he tempted even Billy. Billy had a kite, and as Billy was flying the kite, maybe he too came there, and Tom was telling, look how nice my fence is, what a good job I got, painting the fence is so much of fun, you know, like that he might have told. Then Billy again might have got tempted, Arre, please Tom, give me one chance, I will paint the fence. That way he gave the chance to Billy and he nicely enjoyed flying the kite. When Billy was tired, Johnny Miller gave his pair of marbles. Yeah, the same way maybe Johnny Miller was playing marbles and he saw these two people painting the fence and he came there and he asked Tom for a chance to paint the fence. So Tom was playing the marbles and this Johnny Miller was painting the fence. This way he made each one of them paint the fence one by one. Yeah, and Johnny Miller gave him his pair of marbles to Tom and took the brush. Tom was really in wealth at the end of the day. Wealth means he really enjoyed the day more than any other Saturday. Okay, he might have planned only one game, but today he had so many games. He ate an apple, he flew a kite, he played the marbles, he took rest. Moreover, he finished the painting work also. Everybody paid him a price to get a chance to whitewash the fence. He really enjoyed the day. Yeah, everyone was giving him something and they were painting the fence. They came to laugh at Tom, but he made them work. So how intelligent Tom is. They came to make fun of Tom, but he spoke with them in such a way that they themselves started working and he was enjoying over there. The whole fence was nicely whitewashed with 3 coats of paint within afternoon. So by afternoon, the whole fence was painted with 3 coating. First coating over, yeah. Ben Rogers did it, second coating. Billy did it, third coating. Johnny Miller did it. So this way, the fence was very much shining with good paint, okay. When Aunt Polly saw the fence, she said in surprise. Now Aunt Polly was very happy. She thought that Tom would not work because it was very difficult to make Tom work, that too on Saturdays. But the paint was fully done. The fence was completely painted and she was very happy that she thought that Tom had painted the fence. Oh, Tom, you can work when you want to. Only you hardly ever want to. So she felt very happy thinking that Tom had painted the fence, and she appreciated him, telling, "Are, you are a good workman. You have painted very nicely. Very good job," she said. "And you can work when you want. Whenever you want, you have a good mindset. Whenever you want to work, you work so nicely," she said. "But only thing, you are lazy. You don't want to work. That is only your drawback," she said. She took him home and gave him the best apple she had and allowed him to go and play. Now look at this. After this morning onwards itself, he is playing and enjoying. And after the painting of the fence also, aunt gave him an apple, a good apple, or you can say the best apple. Yeah, and then she gave him time to play. So you can see that Tom enjoyed the whole day. That Saturday was the best Saturday, you can say, where he enjoyed more than the other Saturdays. Okay, this is an extract from The Adventures of Tom Sawyer. This is a book. Tom Sawyer, Adventures of Tom Sawyer is a book, and this is an extract, means a part, a little part from that book. Okay, and this book is written by Mark Twain. Mark Twain is the author of the book Adventures of Tom Sawyer. Okay, who is Mark Twain? Mark Twain, whose real name was Samuel Langhorne Clemens, was an American writer. He is best remembered as a man who gave the immortal characters of Tom Sawyer and Huckleberry Finn. So Tom Sawyer and Huckleberry Finn are very special characters in English literature, wherein you see the mischief, the naughtiness, the happiness of childhood days, and what all secrets and all we have. All these we find in the stories of Adventures of Tom Sawyer, and the characters Tom Sawyer and Huckleberry Finn are very famous for that. Hope you enjoyed this session. Thank you for watching. Kindly subscribe our channel and share with your friends. Very soon I'll be posting the textual question and answers. Meanwhile, take care. Bye-bye.